few years ago, I would have asked myself, is it real or is it not real? And I probably would have said, I think it's real. Tonight, as the sun goes down in Arizona, after 5,000 miles of driving, I have my doubts. An old friend going out on the hill tonight. Some other old friends driving up to South Dakota, hang from trees. Trucks with tanks on the back of them. And fucking hillbillies on the radio. Driving across the desert, it's a good idea to check your gas gauge. Make sure you got enough. I just passed another one. When we were in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, next to that steel plant, and the big crashing noise it made, Tim and Jim and Scott and Joe rescued a junkyard dog that was covered with mangy sores. And one day, and that was the meanest dog I ever saw. Some kind of American pit bull mix, and it would take off running, and the length of its chain stopped just short of the sidewalk going up to the back door. And every time, in its sprint of rage, it would come within inches of the person walking on that sidewalk, and that dumbass dog would boomerang when the line went taut. Of the country, the limits of its temper, the depth of its dream, ever makes more sense than it does when you're driving across the country on the gray asphalt and the lines, the lights of the radio towers in the distance flashing on and off. The sun going down. I'm not going over the speed limit because I can't afford a ticket. or is it time when a drive between Flagstaff and Santa Fe would take me 4.5 hours, and the one from LA to Flagstaff would take me about the same length of time? It's like the little car that I was driving folded and bended the clock. Melted away. Those were the epic days of ceremonies along a parallel line stretching from Austin to green grass. City to Portland, Oregon, across the skyline of Idaho, through the dusty towns of Wyoming, the strange rocks of Utah, the whirling clouds of West Virginia. The beautiful fall leaves of Brown County. The strange expanse of the High Plains. Signs with miles would come and go, and it always made a lot of sense to have a good navigator. But now I've made these trips so many times, I don't really even look at the atlas anymore. The freeways are like old friends, tell me stories and sunset, sunrise, colors. Make wishes come true, only to make them disappear. As soon as you pulled off into a gas station, dirty bathrooms and expensive shitty food, worse coffee, sometimes it was ice on the pavement, sometimes wind, sometimes it was stars in the sky, sometimes it was the voice of a companion trying to keep you awake so you could get wherever it was you were going on time. Trying to ruin it, and the Robin Barons trying to own it, and the Bakesters getting a piece of it, and the DOT dropping the ball, leaving big potholes on my sacred road. torn and shredded bodies. Clawed out of wrenched metal. Mom was crying for the babies. Babies crying for the mamas. My first drive was with Jim Keys. I think it was a Fairlane or an F car. What a piece of shit that thing was. But he kept it clean and it ran great. We always had a bottle of bourbon in it. We wrote 50 songs in a month. The only person that ever sings them anymore is Jim. Up in his pretty house in California, state capital, Sacramento. Actually outside, closer to Johnny Cash, Folsom Lake. Good guitars and mandolins and stuff. In a little room with a little closet. But I remember when Scott O'Grady played long-ass guitar solos to three or four people in shitty, depraved, beer-stained nights. Colored with ink and cigarette coals. Piss-stained mirrors and broken teeth. There's stains on her fingers and I tried to spruce it up with some nice studs and aesthetic drama. Well, Tim tried to turn everything into a pop song that angels would like. You don't like to talk about your brothers this way. Mainly because who else would understand? Get in your car, get on a motorcycle like Tim did, and drive across America. Because you should. Most expensive form of meditation ever invented. Covered up by clouds and whisk off the bushes and dirt. This beautiful, fine place. And it's always a twang, you know? It's always a funny lilt to your voice. Something like poetry, but closer to rusted fenders. Things torn up and put back together. And always so much waste. You wouldn't think that a rear view mirror could be so filled up with light until someone's on you, on your tail, with his brights on, riding you. No place to turn. No point in slowing down or speeding up. I sure as hell wouldn't want to try that on me. But you know there are dinosaurs in Holbrook, and America's got a petrified forest of people. Asking you, where's your soul gonna go when you die? And 100 million people reading a purpose-driven life, afraid to go into the streets to tear down the signs of Wells Fargo and them by or Congress. I went so deep into it, couldn't stop typing. These old hands so tired from beating things. Ticky-tack on the computer till my stomach got swollen and my back got bent. My hips got worn out. Worse than any Thai boxing ever did. But if I had a gun rack, I'd put a bow in it. And if I had a gun, I'd bullets in it. If I had a Grand Canyon, I'd go and sit at the edge of it and watch the sun go down over the behind it. Like I did on the beach of Kauai. Waimea, Kailia, little surf kids, little shredders, fishing out the first day since the rains came, flushing pigs out of the mountains into the waters where the sharks were feeding. That didn't stop those kids from bringing up their shortboards and running S's across those really kind of tacky waves, but fuck, at least they were waves that they could get on. It's like keeping a fat person away from the refrigerator. You go to Dumbo in New York and you're just sitting there wondering, people painting. Were they trying to impress Jerry Saul? Really? It's hard to believe. But I guess you get caught up. Get caught up with the dream of being Michael Jordan in the NBA. And that jumper against Utah. Throwing a bow that the ref loves you too much to call. Not wanting to break up the moment. I'm mean, I wasn't gonna mention sports. It's hard not to. I already drove through McLean, Texas. I already drove past the biggest cross and the shorter one over there in West Virginia. Lula's waiting on me at home. And it'll be a pretty reunion. Wedding blankets in the back. The baby blanket. My dad in his bed trying to nap. Cathedral Park, hanging out with some girl with an Asian name. Not his girlfriend, just a ride. Glenn up in the city, plotting subterfuge. Really just inspired. Those beautiful kids are Rosita's and Mike's. Little containers for everything that ever was good. And I wouldn't dare stop them, boys, if I were you. Making it all the way to the golden ring. Or else a big man will come looking. He'll find you. That's no curse. That's a promise. Flashing light in the sky. Feel a rumble under the dirt. Hear a song on a fiddle somewhere over the edge of the forest. Like in Tennessee when you come out of the Smokies. Ohio and its farms. Chicago with its gray, gray winter afternoons. Blue, wet, angry faces. Grim set against the blowing wind. That's nothing like Scotland. They never did figure out how to build roads over there. They're just fucking death traps. What with roundabouts and turnouts. The little cars that don't amount to nothing. The gas. $15 a fucking gallon. got is a certain kind of truth that comes from having your great, 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 great grandfather's language rolling across hills and tongues even today.